Hi guys, welcome back. Today we are looking into 40 questions from NATA 2021 attempt 1 with questions and their solutions. Starting with question number 1, a solar eclipse will take place when? Options A, the sun is between the moon and the earth. B, the earth is between the moon and the sun. The moon is between the sun and the earth. D, the moon does not lie on the line joining the sun and the earth. And the right answer is option C, as you can see in the image shown above, where the moon is in between the sun and the earth. Next, what should be the minimum height of a plane mirror required to view the full image of a person who is 6 feet tall? Options A, 3 feet, B, 6 feet, C, 4 feet, D, 5 feet. And the right answer is option A, 3 feet. Like you can see in the image, we need half of the height of the person. Next, a jet engine works on the principle of conservation of which of the following? Options A, angular momentum, B, linear momentum, C, energy mass, D, mass velocity. And the right answer is option B, linear momentum. Next, what is the cause of twinkling of stars? Options A, atmospheric pollution, B, atmospheric reflection, C, atmospheric refraction, D, atmospheric dispersion. And the right answer is option C, atmospheric refraction, like you can see in the above image. Stars are visible to us through several layers of atmosphere, which vary in density. Turbulence in the atmosphere causes some of the light from the stars to get refracted. This makes stars appear as though they are twinkling. In reality, stars do not twinkle. It is merely an optical illusion. Moving on, the speed of light will be the minimum while passing through which of the following? Options are A, vacuum, B, air, C, water, D, glass. And the right answer is option D, glass. As you can see in the image, there is no diamond in the option, hence the right answer is glass. Moving on, for a given circle with a center O and radius OA, if two arcs B and C are drawn on the circumference of the circle from 1 by taking the measurement of OA as the radius of the arc, what will be the shape of the triangle obtained by joining the points 1, D and C? And the options are A, an isosceles triangle, B, a scalene triangle, C, a right angle triangle, D, an equilateral triangle. And the right answer is option D, an equilateral triangle. Next, when the sum of two angles make 90 degrees, what are the angles referred to as? Options A, complementary angles, B, supplementary angles, C, acute angles, D, obtuse angles. And the right answer is option A, complementary angles. Moving on, these are all answers from the mathematics section. Next, if a straight line is used to connect V3, what will be the angle formed between the lines V3 and V1? This is the diagram. And the options are A, 30 degree, B, 45 degree, C, 60 degree, D, 90 degree. And the right answer is option A, 30 degree. Moving on, which of the following solids may not be generated by revolving a planar surface along an axis? Options are A, cylinder, B, cone, C, prism, D, sphere. And the right answer is option C, prism. Moving on, find the angle of X from the figure given below. Options are A, 110, B, 120, C, 140, D, 160. And the right answer is option C, 140. Moving on, replace the underlined word with an answer choice such that the meaning of the sentence does not change. As a free marketer, I hate monopoly of any sort, be it economic, cultural, or social. So this is the question from the language section, and the options are A, corruption, B, control, C, opposition, D, optimism. So the right answer is option B, control. Moving on, in question below, there is a sentence which is incomplete. The sentence has to be completed by using parts which are labeled P, Q, R, and S. To produce the correct sentence, choose the proper sequence of the parts to complete the sentence. She sat ... that is P, through the town hall park, Q, which flanked a path running, R, under the boughs, S, of a spreading tamarind tree. And the options are A, PQSR, B, RSQP, C, RSPQ, D, PRSQ. And the right answer is option B, that is, she sat under the boughs of a spreading tamarind tree which flanked a path running through the town hall park. Again, a language-based question. Next, In sentence given below, a part of the sentence is italicized and underlined. Below are given alternatives to be italicized and underlined part which may improve the sentence. Choose the correct alternative. In case no improvement is needed, your answer will be option D. India gained independence in the year 1947 at 12 a.m. on 15th August. And the options are A, on 15th August in the year 1947 at 12 a.m. B, in the year 1960 on 15th August at 12 a.m. C, at 12 a.m. on 15th August in the year 1947. D is the answer with no improvement. So here clearly the option B is ruled out, and hence the right answer is option C, because option A is not a right way. Moving on, in the question below, four words printed in bold type are given. These are lettered A, B, C and D. One of the words may be wrongly spelled or inappropriate in the context of the sentence. Find out the word that is inappropriate to context or wrongly spelled. Options A, to solve a, B, problem one needs to have, C, intelligent and firm, D, determination. And the right answer is option C. So this one was a wrong question, and candidates who have attempted the question will be awarded with full marks. Next, select the pair which has same relationship, grain and salt. Options are A, shard and pottery, B, shred and wood, C, blades and grass, D, chip and glass. And the right answer is option D, that is chip and glass, because it is grain and salt. That is the material quality of glass or salt. We can here consider that the language-based questions were more in number when compared to the other subjects. Next, carefully read the passage given below and provide the answers to the four questions based on the passage. Pratik, a professional man who had worked in an office for many years, had a fearful dream. In it, he found himself in a land where small slug-like animals with slimy tentacles lived on people's bodies. The people tolerated the slothsome creatures because they, after many years, grew into elephants, which then became the nation's system of transport, carrying everywhere wherever he wanted to go. Pratik suddenly realized that he himself was covered with these things, and he woke up screaming. In a vivid sequence of pictures, this dream dramatized for Pratik what he had never been able to put into words. He saw himself as letting society feed on his body in his nearly years so that he could carry him when he retired. He later grew off the security bug and took up freelance work. So the question for this passage is, in his dream, Pratik found the sloth moth creatures were options in his village, in his own house, in a different land, in his office. And the right answer is option C, in a different land. Next question to the same paragraph. Which one of the following phrases best helped to bring out the precise meaning of loathsome creatures? Options A, security bug and slimy tentacles, B, fearful dream and slug-like animals, C, slimy tentacles and animals, D, slug-like animals and security bug slug-like. And the right answer is option C, slimy tentacles and animals. Next, here is another passage, that is, carefully read the passage given below and provide the answers to the four questions based on the passage. Until the end of his first year at school, Vedant retained many of the pleasures and pursuits he had brought him from home, and he kept an old interest in butterflies and fossils. His grandmother had pretended him as a fine bird's egg cabinet, but he could never bring himself to risk in climbing trees. Once or twice, he dissected dead birds from sheer determination to overcome his horror of the operation. Probably it was his envy of those physical unlike himself that brought on a phase during which he drew massive athletics with thick neck and square shoulders. Again, he was pitying himself for what he would never be. So the question for this passage is, the reason why Vedant made drawing of athletes was that option A, though he admired him, he lacked a fine physique himself. B, he loved violent exercise. C, athletics was a passion with him. D, he had to complete an assignment. And the right answer is option A, that is, though he admired them, he lacked a fine physique himself. Next question for the same passage is, Vedant did not want to climb trees because he, options A, loved to play on the ground. B, was scared of falling down. C, disliked trees. D, thought it was childish. And the right answer is option B, was scared of falling down. another paragraph-based question. Carefully read the passage given below and provide the answers to the four questions based on the passage. The assault on the purity of the environment is the price that we pay for many of the benefits of modern technology. For the advantage of automatic transportation, we pay a price in smog-induced diseases. For the powerful effects of new insecticides, we pay a price in dwelling wildlife and disturbance in the relation of living things and their surroundings. For nuclear power, we risk the biological hazards of radiation. By increasing agriculture production with fertilizers, we worsen water pollution. The highly developed nations of the world are not only the immediate beneficiaries of the good that technology can do, they are also the first victims of environmental diseases that technology breeds in the past. The environmental effects which accompanied technological progress were restricted to a small and relatively short time. The new hazards are neither local nor brief. Air pollution covers vast areas of continents, and radioactive fallout from the nuclear explosion is worldwide. Radioactive pollutants now found on the Earth's surface will be for generations, and in the case of carbon-14, for thousands of years. So here's the question for this paragraph. The widespread use of insecticides has options: reduce the number of wildlife, cause imbalance two in the relation between living beings and their environment, C, eliminated disease by killing mosquitoes and flies, caused biological hazards. And the right answer is option B, as mentioned in the paragraph, caused imbalance in the relationship between living beings and their environment. Next question is, the passage emphasizes that modern technology, option A, has benefited highly developed nations, is an unmixed blessing, has produced powerful chemicals, has caused serious hazards to life. And the right answer is option D, because all the other options are totally opposite. Next, according to the passage, the increasing use of fertilizers is responsible for options: abundance of food, B, disturbance in the ecological system, C, water pollution, D, increase in disease. And the right answer is option C, water pollution, as mentioned in the passage again. Another question from the same passage. The harmful effects of modern technology are option A, widespread but short-lived, B, widespread and long-lasting, C, limited and long-lasting, D, but short-lived. And the right answer is option B, widespread and long-lasting. Another paragraph, and like you can see, these all are language based questions, and you need to brush your language skills like we have talked about in the last video. Carefully read the passage given below and provide the answers to the four questions based on the passage. A casual horrors and real disasters are thrown at the newspaper reader without discrimination. In the contemporary arrangements for circulating the news, an important element, evaluation is always weak and often wanting entirely. There is no point anywhere along the line where someone puts his foot down for certain and say this is important and that does not amount the row of beans, deserves no one's attention and should travel the wires no farther. The junk in dressed up to look as meaningful as the real news. So the question for this paragraph is, evaluation of news would amplify which of the following? Options are A, less dependence on modern system of communication, B, more careful analysis of each news story and its value, C, separating beans from junk, D, discriminating horrors from disasters. And the right answer is obviously B, which says more careful analysis of each news story and its value. Another question from the same paragraph. The writer of the above passage, options A, seems to be happy with the contemporary arrangements for circulating news, B, shocked by the casual stories about horror and disaster reports in the newspaper, C, wants better evaluation of news before publication, D, wants to put his foot down on news stories. And the right answer is option C, which says wants better evaluation of news before publication. Another question, in the above passage, the phrase amounts to a row of beans means that the news, options are, is weak and often wanting entirely, B, deserves no man's attention, C, should travel the wires, D, is junk dressed up as real news. And the right answer is option B, that is, deserves no one's attention. Next, newspapers lack a sense of discrimination because A, they do not separate the real news from mere sensationalism, B, they have to accept whatever is received on the wires, C, limited manpower makes serious evolution impossible, D, people don't see the difference between junk and real news. And the right answer is option A, that is, they do not separate the real news from mere sensationalism. Another passage, carefully read the passage given below and provide the answers to the four questions based on the passage. Many sociologists have argued that there is a functional relationship between education and economic system. They point to the fact that mass formal education began in industrial society. They note that the expansion of the economies of industrial societies is accompanied by an corresponding expansion of the educational system. They explain this correspondence in terms of the needs of industry for skilled and trained manpower, needs which are met by the educational system. Thus, the provision of mass elementary education in Britain in 1870 can be seen as a response to the needs of industry for a literate and numerate workforce at a time when industrial processes were becoming more complex and the demand for technical skills was steadily growing. Here's a question to the passage. The industry needs a literate workforce because options A, its expansion needs sound learning. B, it relies heavily on expertise. C, it promotes a competitive spirit. D, its operations need intricate technical knowledge. And the right answer is option D, its option need intricate technical knowledge. Next question is, the author argues that option A, formal education can be traced to industrial society. B, industrial society is responsible for expansion of education at mass level. Industrial society gave rise to vocational education. D, industrial society changed the pattern of education. And the right answer is option A, that is, formal education can be traced to industrial society. Next, the observation of the sociologists as based on a study of options A, the statistical data available in a historical context, B, economic system of the 19th century, C, the correlation between industry and education in a historic context, D, growth of industry in the 19th century, and the right answer is option D, that is, growth of industry in the 19th century. Moving on. The sociologists refer to it in the passage, say that the relationship between industry and elementary education was one. Options A, based on mutual need, B, based entirely on the need of the industry, C, based entirely on economic need, D, based on some inexplicable historical forces. And the right answer is option B, that is, based entirely on the need of the industry. Moving on, here is some different question. The highlighted area in the image of the Taj Mahal below is given a decorative treatment different from that of the upper part of the wall. What is the architectural terminology of the same? So the options are A, skirting, B, trashery, C, plinth, D, dado. And the right answer is option D, that is, dado. So dado in architecture is the lower part of the wall below your waist level, which is below the dado rail and above the skirting board, like you can see in the image. Moving on, another architectural vocabulary question, that is, identify the kind of roofing system used in the structure below. And the options are A, dome, B, vault, C, shell, D, arcade. And the right answer is option B, that is, vault. So these are vaults and not dome. Moving on, the set of images given below indicate a functional and structural element that protrudes from the plane of the sloping roof surface. What is the correct terminology for the element? Options are A, bay window, B, hipped window, C, dormer window, D, clerestory window. And the right answer is option C, that is, dormer window. Always a window which is protruded out from a sloping roof is a dormer window. Moving on, the image of the vernacular dwelling given below displays an architecture that is responsible for tropical climate and context. In which tropical country can this type of dwelling be found? Options are A, Suriname, B, Indonesia, C, Ecuador, D, Jamaica. And the right answer is option B, that is, Indonesia. So these are the dwellings found in Indonesia according to the tropical climate and the context of the country. Last one for this video. To which cultural aesthetic and landscape do the elements such as tea house, dry landscape, garden, treasure, tower, pagoda, drum, bridge, tree, water, and rocks attributed? Options A, Japanese, B, Vietnamese, C, Taiwanese, D, Mongolian. And the right answer is option A, that is, Japanese. So here we come to the end of the video. I hope this was helpful and will help you for your attempt 2, which is now postponed to July 11th, considering the situation. So make sure you use this extra time for your good. See you, bye.